So I'm Thorsten Höffler from ETH Zurich. I'm here together with Costas Bekas from the IBM Research Lab in Zurich at the PASC16 conference, the interdisciplinary conference that for this year, for the first time, has a papers track, in fact. So Costas, what have you been doing so far here and how have you been enjoying yourself?
Thank you very much, Thorsten. It has been a really very nice event. This is the third time I come to this event since its beginning, and I think I like very much the way that it has been evolving into getting a structure that that can make it actually a top venue for computational scientists to present the top-notch work they're doing all around Europe and across the world.
So you have been actually chairing a mini symposium or organizing a mini symposium on big data, one of the central topics in this year's PASC conference. So can you summarize a little bit what the content of the symposium was, what the talks were, what are the new insights that you may have gained?
Sure. So essentially what happens is that we are seeing the convergence of mainstream big data computing into what would be characteristics of a high performance computing workload. So and then the question is very simple to the people that are HPC, like how can I help, and is this a new market for me? And the second one is these guys in big data, they know a lot about workflows. How can we get help from their experience into moving into the world of virtualization and actually consumption of HPC in a much better way?
So what would you say, how can we help?
So what we can help is that the big data community is discovering the importance of operating system hooks. It's discovering the importance of improved communication systems. It's discovering the importance of algorithms that are actually low complexity. And this is something that the high-end HPC community has been doing for decades, right? So that part, it's definitely something that we can help a lot. But the idea is to actually open up our mentality so that we can do it, right? So we cannot be in this entrenched world where anything that is not looking exactly like HPC is not interesting for us. On the contrary, this is a big opportunity for HPC to actually move and help society in other fields that are very, very important. I like to think of it like ABS for cars or ignition systems, low pollution systems. We're pioneered in Formula One and in Grand Prix motor racing, right? So we can be doing exactly the same thing from HPC to the big data community.
Okay, so but also HPC is evolving, right? We've seen the very interesting keynote yesterday by Mark Sneer, where he mentioned the end of Moore's Law, of course, which is clear to happen, and then talking about the post-Moore era. And IBM is doing some ideas into this direction, especially cognitive computing. So how would you relate this to current HPC? So how does cognitive computing relate to that?
Yeah, so if you look at cognitive computing, which is essentially a way to mimic the way the human thought processes, so that when you have a system giving you a decision, it's not like a black box, but actually has a reasoning behind it. This does not mean that this process is not using hardcore numerical kernels. Actually, it's using all the time hardcore numerical kernels. And then when you see the scale of the problems that we need to solve, for instance, last year alone, only about 400,000 papers have been published in material science, right? So if you would like to make the knowledge graphs to store this information, the methods to actually retrieve this information, the techniques to have the feedback loops, these all become extremely demanding workloads. So IBM is very much interested in first understanding how to make cognitive computing work, put the cognitive computing in new industries to create value for our clients, but second also, what are the new platforms that we need to be using to make cognitive computing work? This is why we're investing in quantum computing. This is why we're investing in neuromorphic computing. And this is why we're also investing in general in post-von Neumann computing.
So would this be correct to say that cognitive computing is kind of merging experiences from high-performance computing as well as data representation and big data in this sense?
Yes, and putting that on top the research and the developments needed to understand how to put human thought processes and experience into the mix.
Okay, wonderful. So we are actually expecting or hoping for your submission next year to the ACM PASC papers track. So thank you very much, Costas.
I'll be here.